Alright, so hello everyone, this is Coach Lin and welcome back to my channel. So today's video, we'll talk about how to free yourself from anxiety. So anxiety and worry can take over your life if you allow it to. Whether we like it or not, constant stress and worry can physically make us sick. So especially at this moment, as I record this video, we are on the 32nd day of the enhanced community quarantine. So I hope that you are all safe, we are all safe and healthy. So magtulong-tulong po tayo to stay at home and limit muna natin yung mga outdoor activities. But it doesn't mean na ililimit natin lahat. Yun nga, yung term before na social distancing, we're using physical distancing. So let's stay socially connected pa rin. So the good news about dito sa anxiety na pinag-uusapan natin is that there are ways to help alleviate anxiety. Yung first step natin is to figure out exactly what you're stressing about. So yun yung pinakamag-uusapan natin ngayon, especially yun nga, 32nd day na, and marami na sa atin yung naka-experience ng worry, anxiety. There are so many reasons and there are so many factors for us para ma-experience yun. So yung una natin gawin dito is let's identify ano ba talaga yung nagpapastress sa atin. Is it something we can change? Or is it something na may control tayo? So, pagka alam natin kung ano ba yung anxiety na yon at kung may control ba tayo dito, madali nating ma-identify ano ba yung root of anxiety natin. Kung na-identify na natin yung root niya, you can better understand how you can overcome it. So, for example, if you're feeling anxious about losing your job, you have the capability to change this worry. So, ngayon yung mga samples natin. Yung iba, di ba, no work, no pay. Yung iba, hindi alam kung may babalikan pa silang work. Yung iba, hindi na alam yung status ng company. So, yun, maraming ganun mga examples natin. However, you can work, kung yun yung example natin. So, for example, anxiety mo is you're anxious or you're feeling anxious about losing your job. Pwede natin sagot sa kanya is you can work harder to prove that you're an indispensable part of the team, or you can start searching for a new job. Okay, so taking action is the surest way to defeat anxiety. So instead of thinking yung anxiety na yon or yung situation na yon, why not take action para ma-address kung ano man yung nagkakos ng anxiety natin. So the truth is, there are plenty of situations in your life that you can change with some effort. So for example, and this here's another example. If you're concerned about your weight, yan. The good news is that you can change it. You already know it takes a healthy diet coupled with regular exercise. So little by little, your weight will melt away and your health will improve. Okay, so by determining the root of your anxieties and developing ways to turn them into something positive, you can often overcome them. So next is I'm going to share to you 6 tips and techniques on how, ito yung techniques na to, to help you manage your anxiety or how can we overcome yung anxiety na yun. So yung first natin is, okay, know your anxieties. Now, here's the activity that I can share to you. If you have pen and paper, ito yung susulat natin. If not, you can play na lang later yung video or note natin later, either sa phone natin or kung saan natin siya pwedeng ilagay. Here's the activity. Write down exactly what's causing your anxiety. So, ano ba talaga? So, ngayon, sa current status mo, what's causing your anxiety? Then, note down ways. So, for example, na-identify mo na. Kung marami yan, lagay mo siya, numberan mo siya. So, ano yung mga nagkakos sa'yo ng anxiety? Then, note down ways you can change the outcome. Knowing what you're up against is the key to feeling better about yourself and your current situation. So, yung important na keyword natin for this one, how are we going to identify or how are we going to know your anxieties or yung anxieties natin? First is, ano yung ba yung mga causes? Okay, so write down natin siya. Ano yung nagko-cause ng anxiety mo? Okay, if more than one yan, list down mo yan lahat. And then, kung wari, meron kang 5 na nakalista, so by number, kunyari sa number 1, ano yung cost, and then ano yung possible outcome niya, ano yung nagiging outcome niya sa'yo. Okay? So, yun yung first natin. Now, next one is breathe. Once you've pinpointed the things you need to change, sit back and take a breath. So, this form of relaxation can help you calm your racing heart and give you peace of mind. Okay, remember, rapid breathing from anxiety can lead to a panic attack. Don't let it get that far. Okay, so be kind to yourself. Monitor natin yan lagi. Breathe deeply and slowly as soon as you feel yourself become worried or anxious. Pag hindi mo na alam kung ano yung nangyayari sa'yo, ano yung gagawin mo, worry ka ng worry, andyan yung anxiety. So, stop ka lang muna, take a minute, and then take a breath. Okay? So, if you watch yung last na video ko about COVID-19 ROI, I shared doon sa video na yun, yung take 1 minute of your time to practice breathing. So, inhale. So, once you inhale, you're inhaling courage. And then, pag exhale natin is fear. So, take 1 minute of your time. Just 1 minute. And then, upo ka lang. Take your time. 1 minute, mag-breathe ka. So, once you inhale, inhale through your nose. And exhale through your mouth. And mas maganda yung pag-exhale natin, may sounds. And imagine that yung in-exhale natin is yung fear mo. So, inhale courage. Since we're talking about anxiety, ano yung mga dapat nating i-feed? Ano yung dapat natin na makuha? So, inhale courage and then exhale fear. So, again, practice that 1 minute lang po ng time natin. Okay? And then next, visualize. So, what are we going to visualize naman? So, dito, perhaps, one of the most effective ways to overcome anxiety is the technique of visualization. Choose a quiet space in your home, especially yung mga naka-uwi kasama yung family nila. Pili kayo ng isang area sa bahay nyo, and then pwedeng light some candles or basta dun sa quiet na area. Ikaw lang sana yon. So, eto, give time to yourself na rin. And then, close your eyes. So, again, dun sa part ng bahay nyo, saan ka dun komportable, dun ka mag-take ng moment, make sure na ikaw lang din yung mag-isa dun, and, ayun, take your time. Yun sa quiet place na yun, sa quiet area na yun, sa quiet part ng bahay mo, and then close your eyes. Now, kung na-close mo na yung eyes mo, nandyan ka na, i-feel mo, practice breathing din, inhale, exhale, and then once comfortable ka na, imagine yourself in your ideal situation. What is your ideal situation? Ano yung pinapangarap mo na yon? Feel how calm you are and visualize letting go of your worries. Think about how happy you'll be once your source of stress has been diminished. Okay? Positive visualization can help you move toward the happier vision you've created in your mind. Okay, again, find your quiet place and then do natin gawin yung visualization. Okay? And then, let go all of the worries. Imagine, mag-focus tayo dun sa ideal situation natin. And then, let go natin lahat ng mga worries natin. Alright? So, next is, use positive affirmations. So, when things get tough and you feel yourself losing control, repeat a positive statement over and over in your head. So, for example, if you're in need of a job, you can repeat something like, I am a valuable and hardworking individual who is worthy of a fulfilling new opportunity. So, again, dito din, let's avoid yung negative self-talk na laging ang bobo ko, hindi ko kaya to, malito, eto lang ako. So, let's stop that. Okay? Hindi siya makakatulong din sa atin and mag-i-increase pa siya dun sa worry and anxiety natin. So, Ito yung pwede ko masuggest na i-practice natin. So, I am. So, yung statement na I am, dugsungan mo siya. I am what? I am generous. I am happy. I am joyful. I am positive. I am flexible. I am gifted. I am worth it. So, yun, lagi mo siyang sabihin sa sarili mo. Kung may problema ka sa work ngayon, di natin alam kung ano yung after ECQ, ano yung mangyayari. Still, sabihan mo pa rin na you're valuable, you're confident, you're worthy. So, ano yung I am mo? Ayan, so eto, pwede mo rin siyang isulat, tapos pwede mo siyang i-post para ma-remind mo yung sarili mo about dun sa I am na statement mo. Ako, what I am doing is, meron akong reminder dun sa phone ko, tapos nakalagay dun is, I am worthy of this job. So, every day, I'm reminding myself, naka-alarm siya every 12 noon. So, bakit 12 noon? Kasi 12 noon yung break. Kung tama yung oras ng pagbe-break ko. So, 12 noon, mag-alarm siya, mare-remind ako na kahit na, ganun yung na-experience ko sa work, kahit mahirap siya, kahit sobrang busy, yun, I am worth it nung job na yun. So, I am the best person for that job. So, yun yung lagi ko nire-remind sa sarili ko. So, ang importance nito is reaffirming positive thoughts repeatedly can help you believe that anything is possible. The power of the mind is endless. So, again, avoid natin yung negative self-talk. Tapos, yung i-feed lang natin is yung mga positive information, positive affirmation dun sa mind natin. Okay? And then, next, eto. Marami ang since next year, January, marami ang naglagay sa goal nila nito. Okay, diet and exercise. What is the connection of this diet and exercise dito? O paano siya makakatulong to overcome yung anxiety natin? So, eating well, yun nga, yung may exercise ka, may tamang pagkain. So, eating a well-balanced diet and exercising can physically help you handle stress and anxiety. The stronger the body is, the stronger the mind is. So, dalawa po siya. I remember before nung nagre-review ako for a board exam. Yung tinuro sa amin doon is, syempre, kung nagre-review ka, you need to study, kailangan maintindihan mo lahat, kailangan matandaan mo lahat ng mga pinag-aaralan mo. Pero, sa pagtitake kasi ng board exam, hindi lang siya dapat naka-focus doon sa pag-aaral mo. Hindi lang siya dapat sa mind. Ang mangyayari kasi doon is kung naka-focus lang ikaw sa mind, kung let's say nag-aaral ka, kasi that time nagre-review ako for board exam. So nag-focus ako na nag-focus sa pag-aaral, tapos dumating yung time na alam mo yung moment na parang lutang ka, tapos parang hinahangin yung utak mo, tapos alam mo yung nagpa-function pa rin yung brain mo, continuous pa rin siyang nag-function. So ano yung explanation doon? Pinagod mo yung utak mo, hindi mo pinagod yung katawan mo. So that's why may moment na kailangan niya na mag-rest kasi napagod na siya kakaisip, pero yung body mo hindi niya pa na-feel na kailangan niya mag-rest. Okay? So et kaya ito, dalawa siya, diet and exercise. And when we say diet, we're not talking about ano dito, losing weight lang. Okay? When we say diet is eating the nutritious food, tapos kung ano yung ipifeed mong pagkain sa katawan mo. So, yun siya. It's a fact. If you abuse your body with junk foods or drugs and alcohol, your body and mind will react in a negative way. Siyempre, kung ano yung nilagay mo dyan sa katawan mo, yun din yung ibibalik niya sa'yo. Yun din yung ibibigay niya sa'yo. Kung walang nutrition yung nakukuha niya, wala ding nutrition yung maging reaction ng katawan mo. So, important reminder dito is take good care of your body and it will help take care of your worries. Okay? And especially yan, yung brain natin, kailangan strong din siya. Okay? And for the last one, here's the sixth tip. Support. So, sino ba yung mga alam natin na pwede mag-support sa atin? Where are you getting support? In case ba may challenges ka or may pinagdadaanan or naka-experience ng worry and anxiety, alam mo ba kung sino yung tatawagan mo? So, dito, talk to someone who has been in the same situation. Reaching out to friends and family or seeking professional help can do wonders to help you get rid of your anxiety. Now, dito naman, meron tayong mga sinasabi na, di ba anyone, especially in the Philippines, anyone can give advice. Pero ang concern natin dito is, if you're experiencing worry and anxiety na, hindi lang basta advice yung kailangan natin. You need to seek professional advice. And dun sa tamang tao, yung makakausap sana natin. Kasi, yun nga, pag sinabi na, since libre lang yung advice, marami naman sa atin na kaya namang mag-advise. Pero yung question dun is, are we getting the right advice ba? Okay? So, pwede kang kumuha ng advice sa friend mo, sa relative, sa churches, if you need prayers, if you need counseling, if you need guidance. Most of the churches ngayon ay, since, di ba, wala na rin naman, kailangan i-practice natin yung physical distancing. So, marami sa kanila nag-online. So, kung hindi ka comfortable makipag-usap sa friend mo, sa relative mo, sa family mo, why not talk to them online or so kung kanina pa. We also have life coaches. Ayan, meron tayo in our tribe. We have, you can message us. If you're not comfortable na tawag, pwede naman siyang chat. Pero ayun, wala pa rin kasi yung face-to-face na coaching ngayon since we need to follow yung, ayun, naka-ECQ tayo. Plus, bawal pa rin talagang lumabas. And practice physical distancing. So yun, always remember, help is available. Ang kailangan lang is you need to acknowledge na kailangan mo rin ng tulong. Kasi yung tulong, hindi naman siya basta darating lang. Tapos, ayun, kasi yung pagtulong, hindi rin natin alam kung sino yung mga nangangailangan. Kung hindi mo sasabihin na kailangan mo ng tulong, paano siya darating? Okay? Once you've seen that someone else has gone through and overcome what you're experiencing, it gives you great hope that you too can do the same. So, yun, hanap ka, sino ba yung naka-experience na nito? Paano niya ito na-overcome? Ano kaya yung mga nagawa niya? And then, pwede mo siyang kausapin. Okay? So, in summary, yan. Here are the 6 tips and techniques to help you manage your anxiety. Yung first kanina is yun, know your anxiety. So, list down natin siya at yung cause and ano yung outcome. Breathe. Visualize. Okay, ito yung activity natin dito is bili ka ng lugar niyo sa bahay wherein you can do yung visualization. And then think yung ano yung ideal situation na gusto mo. And then use positive affirmations. What is your I am? I am blank. So, ikaw na yung magdugtong ano yung kasunod doon. Next, diet and exercise. And then last one is 6 support. So, anxieties are part of everyday life. May COVID or wala, part po yan talaga ng buhay natin. So, how you choose to manage them is what makes the difference. How are we going to react? O, every situation ba, may mga reactions tayo? And then, ano yung reaction natin? Okay? So, stop letting anxiety control you. Again, ikaw yung may control sa buhay mo. Ikaw din yung may hawak. Or ikaw din yung may say kung ano lang yung makaka-affect sa'yo. So, kung anxiety yan, please, huwag mong hayaan na i-control ka nito. So, take the reins and let anxiety and worries know that you are the one in the driver's seat of your life. Do not let the anxiety, do not let the worry controls you. Okay? Huwag nating ibigay sa kanila yung manibela ng buhay natin. Okay? Ikaw yung mag-manage pa rin yan. Remember, you are powerful. So, pwedeng lagay mo siya dun sa I am mo. I am powerful. Ako, kaya kong i-manage itong anxiety na to. Kaya kong i-manage itong worry na to. At hindi ako papatalo dito. Okay? So, that's it for me. Thank you for listening. I hope you learned something from this video. Yun, if you have questions, if you have concerns, you can message me. Here's my social media accounts, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and eto, sa YouTube. Please subscribe. And don't forget to share love and kindness today. See you in my next vlog. Bye!